Hello students, very good morning to all of you. So today we are here again and we are going to start the comprehension, the back exercise of the chapter, the book exercise, okay? And the story, about the story, I have asked some questions including like that who was falcon and who was the pigeon, what was the name of the king, okay? And where did he found the pigeon? What did he do when he saw the pigeon, injured pigeon or a wounded pigeon? Okay. What the falcon ask? What did the falcon ask to the king? And what is the meaning of the carnivorous? Okay. So these are the questions that we have discussed. Like carnivorous is the one who eat meat or flesh, okay. And the name of the king was Shivi, okay. And the falcon and pigeon were the king Indra, the god of gods, the king of gods, and king pigeon was the king Agni, the god of fire. Where did he find the pigeon? He find the pigeon in the garden while walking there. And the next question was what did the falcon ask? The falcon asked to provide the food as an exchange of the pigeon, and that will be the equal amount of flesh from his body. So did the king Shivi was ready to do whatever the falcon asked? Yes, he was. So now comprehension. It's time for comprehension. It's time for the back exercise. First one is A1. Choose the correct answer. King Shivi was famous for. Options are his hunting skills, kindness towards, kindness and good governance. Yes, the answer is C. King Shivi was famous for kindness and good governance. Governance, the ruling criteria. Okay. In return for the pigeon's life, Shivi offered the falcon 100 gold coins, his kingdom, another pigeon. So what he offered? He offered his kingdom. Next, the falcon and the pigeon were actually blank respectively. Respectively means falcon stands for what and pigeon stands for what? Respectively means first you will mention for the falcon and then you will mention for the pigeon. It was Indra and Surya? No. It was Agni and Varuna? No. It was Indra and Agni? No. So what was the answer? Answer C. Indra and Agni. So now we are moving to the next question. Say whether true or false. Shivi did not like falcons. True or false? It is not mentioned. False. Answer is false. The falcon was arguing intelligently. Answer is true. Yes, he was arguing intelligently. At the end of the story, the falcon and the pigeon became friends and they flew away together. No, it was. It is false. Answer this question. This we will later on discuss. We will discuss later on. Okay. We will move to vocabulary. Analogy, read this pair of words. Analogy means predator, prey. Cat, mouse. Predator, prey. And cat, mouse. Means see the relationship. How they are related to each other. Like cat is related to mouse as predator is related to prey. Predator used to eat prey and cat is used to eat mouse. This kind of comparison between two pairs of words is called an analogy. Clear? Clear means cat is related to mouse as predator is related to prey. This kind of comparison between two pairs of words is called an analogy. Here, complete the following analogies with suitable words. When we will do more exercise with this or we will do this exercise, then the concept will be clear to you. Like boy is to girl as blank is to woman. So, boy is to girl. So, man is to woman. Now, July is to August as blank is to February. See, it's not June, July. It's not July, June. It's July is to August. July, August. It means blank is to February. So, what comes before February is January. King is to kingdom as blank is to school. King is to kingdom. King is the head of kingdom. Blank is to school is principal is to school. Who is the head of your school? Principal. Food is to hungry as drink is to, means when we are hungry, we eat food. We eat food when we are hungry. Now see, drink is to thirsty. Okay. Moving to next one. Tear is to sorrow as a smile is to blank. Tear, when we got tears, when we weep, sorrow. So a smile is to happiness. Picture is to blank as carpet is to floor. Where we spread the carpet? We spread the carpet on the floor. So where we hang the picture? It is on the wall. Picture is to wall as carpet is to floor. Wing is to word as fin is to wing. Who is having wing? Word. And fin, who is having fin? Fish. So wing is to word as fin is to fish. Blank is to pipes as electricity is to wires. What runs through wires? Electricity. Or how the electricity runs? It runs through wires. So what runs to pipe through pipes? It's water. Okay. Water is to pipes as electricity is to wires. Now here we are again going to discuss next one. It is predator and prey. So what is this? A predator is an animal that hunts and eats other animals. A prey is an animal that is hunted for food by other animals. Now match the animal types in column A with their description in column B. And second, with examples in column C. Clear? See, these words, terms, you have read about them in science. And always keep in mind that whenever you read English, Hindi, science, SS, these all are just merged with each other. These all are related to each other. If I talk about Hindi, you read Hindi subject in Hindi and every subject is written in English, but everything is related to each other. So we are going to read it. The terms are of science. But if I talk about the vocabulary, then it is in English also. So here we are going to read this. Column A, column B and column C. Column B is a description of column A. C is example. Now you have to match this. Now match the animal types in column A. I will read out the whole first. First is herbivore. Animal that has no spine. Flea, mosquito. Carnivore, animal that eats other dead animals with which it has not killed itself. Crocodile, snake. Vertebrae, animal that eats only plants. Dog, cat. Omnivore, animal that is kept at home as a companion. Tiger, lion, see. Scavenger, small animals with large teeth. Monkey, zebra. Reptile, animal that lives on other animals, often drink their blood. Cow, horse. Invertebrate, animals that eat meats. Rat, squirrel. Pet, animal that lay eggs, has scales on its body and crawls. Vulture, hyena. Rodent, animals that has a spine, worms. Parasite, animal that eats both plants and meat, pig, crow. No. Now, see, what you need to do is to matching. Means A, B and C. It should be in a same sequence. If I am talking about herbivore, then the answer is animal that eats only plants. Okay. Can I say monkey and zebra? Yes. So, I will write the answer herbivore And column third is the answer, animal that eats only plants, and monkey and zebra. First you match, then I'll discuss. And it's easy. Herbivore is vegetable eating or herbs eating. Only plants eating. Carnivore, only flesh eating. Vertebrae, having a spine. Omnivore, flesh and plants both eating. Scavenger, used to eat dead animals. Reptiles, those who move on ground, like snake and crocodile. Invertebrate, no backbone. Pet, you know, rodent and parasite. Parasite are the animals, those who used to live on others. They never prepare their food. Animal that lives on other animal often drink their blood. They are parasite. Okay? Got it? Next. So this you will do and then we will discuss again. It took time, somewhere you use and you write it. Now, this is the brainstorming exercise that I have given to you. Grammar. Adjectives with prepositions. Let's look at the way adjectives are used in the sentence below. King Shivi was famous for kindness and good governance. The pigeon was frightened of the falcon. Here the two words in two sentences, famous for and frightened of. You are being cruel to me. You will have a life full of happiness. Cruel to, full of. The adjectives famous, frightened, cruel and full are used with prepositions for, of, to and of respectively. The table below shows some adjectives that are used with prepositions like adjective, prepositions, preposition, example. How we will use adjective, preposition and what will be the example? Afraid, jealous, tired, full. Keep in mind adjectives. Adjectives are the words that describe a noun or a pronoun. Prepositions are told, tell the situation or the relation between two objects. Okay. And here example. Afraid, jealous, tired, full of. We should not be jealous of successful people. Kind, cruel, similar, thankful to. The king scolded the minister who was cruel to the servant. And I have a bag full of gold coins. The king scolded the minister who was cruel to the servant. The king appreciated the minister who was kind to the servant. See, both. Angry, happy with. Grandfather was angry with the cat for breaking the jar. Famous for, responsible for. Who is responsible for this mess? Who will be responsible for this breakage? You know? Good, bad, surprised at. We are surprised at Manoj's ability to write poems. Different and separate from. Keep your textbook separate from the storybooks. So like this we use it. Okay. And then coming to the next one. Here we are having this exercise. C1. And then punctuation. So we'll discuss it in our next video. This exercise we will do. Okay. And here you will first read this. How to use preposition. Okay. How to use adjective preposition. These are the words that has been given here. Thank you and resume to the next video.